Today, we are discussing the five rules of money. If you are new to this channel, then you should know if you are not rich or poor, you certainly must be in the making. This is Wisdom Formula. Over here, we believe everything is possible once you have a formula to convert your knowledge into wisdom. Money. Some say money is just a concept. Some chase it like we say boots. Some live as though they have it, and some actually have it. Money don't care what you do. Money don't care where you are from. Money doesn't even care the religion that you are in. Money is just simple. You either have it or you don't. You are either spending money or you are making money. So, let's go straight into the video. What a lot of people may not know before watching this video is that money is a system on its own. Money is like a human being. It has principles, it has regulations, money has rules. So today, we are discussing the five rules of money that will change your perspective about wealth and money. Rule number one, money is there for everyone, but it's not for anyone. What do I mean by this? Every single day, if you could perceive, the money in circulation in every economy is for everyone. It's not for some specific kind of people. And in every year, the government prints a lot of money into the economic system. This money the government prints is not printed for some specific high-ranked business. It's printed and put in circulation for everyone. Anyone who wants to take steps to go and find money will get it. But anybody who don't take steps to get money wouldn't get it. Every day, money moves around, moving from person to person and from one hand onto the other. Money is always looking for you to give him a reason to make him stay with you. So if you have a reason to make money stay, money will stay with you. And it's obvious that a lot of people don't have the knowledge or the reason to make money stay with them. So that is why the few people in the environment that actually have a reason to make money stay are called the rich people. To get money requires financial intelligence, and not everybody actually have that intelligence about money. That is why money is for everybody in the economy, but then it's not anyone that understands the concept to get money. Rule number two, lazy money die faster. Take money as a human being. If you are lazy, then you kill your potential and ability of being a successful person. Active and hardworking people are the ones who are able to work their way through to bring their dreams and aspirations to life. So, if you put your money in a savings account, inflation will kill your money. Take your money as a soldier. Every single day, you have to send your soldiers to the battlefield. And then, once they go there, some may die, some may come back. But your responsibility is to make sure that you put in a good strategy to make sure that a lot of your soldiers will come home with more slaves. And that is, the soldiers being money, they bring more slaves, which is also money. So if you keep your money sitting in your bank accounts, then your money is going to reduce and it's going to die. Money hates being lazy. So if you keep your money lazy, it either dies off or it flies to somebody who will put it to work. Money actually hates boredom. That is why it's called currency, which means movement. So it always wants to move. It always wants to be in circulation in order to keep it growing. So buy assets, invest your money, put your money to work. Don't let your money be lazy. Multiply your money. Rule number three, value attracts money. The best investment you can give to yourself is by investing in your own self. People who constantly add value to themselves are those who attract more money. It's even easier to increase your intellect these days. I always say this is the best generation to be alive. There are lots of information on the internet for free. And as a matter of fact, there are lots of things that you can do with your phone and laptop just in your room to make more money. But the sad thing is, a lot of people use it for just entertainment. People don't actually pay you for what you actually know, or they don't even care about your monetary problems. They don't care whether you need money or not. What people care about is the value you can provide them. So once you make yourself valuable, people will run after money and bring it to you in exchange of your skills. So instead of chasing money, instead of trying to look for money, make yourself more valuable. Add value to yourself. Then people will chase you for your value and skills, and that will in turn pay you more money. Rule number four, money is just a tool. Have you ever heard this phrase, money don't change people? I'm sure you are familiar with this phrase, but if you are not, let me explain this phrase to you. Money is just a tool. It just helps people to unveil who they really are. Take for example, if you are an idiot in the first place, getting more money will not make you smart. You just be an idiot with a large amount of money in your bank accounts. Money is like any other tool when you go to the workshop. When you go to the workshop, the tools there don't do the work themselves. It's the mechanic that do the work. It's just that the tool help the mechanic to do or get the job done easily. If you have money, money just gives you access to a lot of things that money can do. Money gives you access to more power and resources. For example, you can't eat money unless maybe you're a rat. Nobody does eat money. What money does is it helps us to eat or get the food that we want to eat. So money just helps us to get the things we want. In actual sense, it's not really money that we want, but then we want money so that we can get the things that we actually want. That is why money is a tool. So for example, if you're a bad person, money don't make you a bad person. A bad person will automatically use money to do bad things, whilst a good person will use money to do good things. So money have always been a tool, but what you use money for depends on you. Rule number 5. It's not about how much you make, but it's about how much you keep. Actually, this is a very important rule of money a lot of people take for granted. Let's take for example, if you are receiving $100,000 in a month and you spend all living lavishly, you are not better than somebody who receives just $1,000 a month and save 30% for investment. People work so hard to get their monies, and once they receive their share, all what they do is to spend it like nobody's business. The rule is, don't or never spend more than you earn. Actually, you can never spend more than you earn, unless maybe you are just borrowing from other source. So never try to spend more than you get. For example, if you really want to make your finances grow, then make sure that any money that you get, you spend less than you get, and you keep as many as possible. And if you really, really want to put this to work, I recommend The Richest Man in Babylon. It's a very good book that will give you a head start. Once you are done reading this book, then you know that you don't have to save what you have after spending, but then you have to spend what you have after saving. If this video was resourceful, don't forget to hit the like button and comment below, which among these rules are you going to put to use, and which other rule do you know that I didn't mention in this video? Comment below and let's have an interaction. Okay. Thank you for watching. If you are new to this channel, or maybe you've been here before but you haven't subscribed to this channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button below here and also click the post notification so you never miss any of our weekly videos. You can also follow Wisdom Formula on Instagram and send me a friend request, as I always say, on Facebook as Mustapha Murphy Mubarak.